3 weeks had passed since the massacre at Bulma Musa. Consumed with revenge, the Wallister took to the battlefield, wresting large swaths of territory from Galgastani control. The Duke's gambit was a success. Yet not all went as the Duke had intended. Though the atrocity galvanized the Wallister, those in the Galgastani camp who opposed their own Hierophant Balbatos did not rise to action. Worse, whispers of the truth behind what happened had begun to spread throughout Galgastan on the lips of Vice and his men. Where the Duke had sought to sow discord, a new sense of unity now grew among the Galgastani people. But the stalemate of forces along the Sonji Weald showed no signs of yielding clear victory to either side. Hoping to strike a decisive blow, the Duke pushed towards Balbatos' stronghold at Kuritanai, a daring, some said reckless, attempt to take the keep. Meanwhile, Denim arrived at the ruins of Bulma Musa with orders to harry the enemy's flank.
I hear no alarm, sister. I think we made it.
By the look of things, the Galgastani can't have stationed many men here. The fewer we must kill to be done with this business, the better.
You would have me fight such a battle with our numbers. Are you gone mad?
I mislike your tone.
Forgive me, Your Grace. We are more powerful now than ever, I grant you. But let us not forget we failed to rouse the Galgastani against Balbatos. Our resistance remains far outmatched.
I do not need you to tell me what I know so well.
Then I beg you to reconsider.
Humor, Your Duke. Hear my plan before you reject it, First, we dispatch a light force to secure Bulma Musa, a small town southwest of Kuritanai. Thence to advance to the Zeod Moors.
You distract them by needling their flank? They will never fall for such a ruse.
Your ears would serve me better than your tongue. I mean to have our young hero lead the band. We will feed sweet lies to their whisperers, that it's no small band, but half our army that marches. A morsel they will find impossible to resist. Nor will they know whether it is from Almorica or Bulma Musa that we strike.
And they will believe this tale.
The presence of the hero of Goliath will convince them. Balbatos would not think we place our hero at the head of so few. This will be enough to give Balbatos pause, but he is no fool. He will not commit the entirety of his forces to Bulma Musa. No, he will divide his men between the Sonji Weald and the Zeod Moors. The martial advantage is his. Even with his forces split, he will not fear defeat. Yet only this way will we have a true chance at victory.
Perhaps. But if Balbatos does not split his troops, what then?
We must see that he does. There's more. Once our heroes have a foothold in Bulma Musa, they will turn their attentions to the port of Ashton to the west. Balbatos will fear an assault, and with his troops mustering in Kuritanai, Ashton will be ripe for the taking.
Of course. Without Bulma Musa or Ashton, they'll be cut off from the sea.
Is that so great a blow?
In Valeria, the sea is life. Without the bounty of her trade, we wither and die. Doubly so, the Galgastani and their landlocked keep at Kuritanai. Believe our rumors or no, they must respond. And that means splitting their troops.
Should the gambit fail, we still weaken them by closing their ports.
What becomes of us?
If you sense disadvantage, withdraw swiftly.
So in the end, we still must fight a battle of Galgastan's choosing.
Oh, you fret like an old maid, Leonar. The plan is perfect.
As you say, Your Grace.
Forward! Leave no Galgastani standing!
Thank you.
Zayard Moors are within our grasp. Onward!